make major strides this year, major steps, but it is going to be a great challenge for all of us. They better be excited about getting ready to go play because he's a good one.
It seemed like last time he was here, he just took a beating. I mean, and just kept getting right back up, and I think that was his freshman year, and we were all pretty impressed by him.
I think that says a lot about him. I mean, that tells you what kind of kid he is, and it shows you, you know, a glimpse of what he was going to be at some point, and unfortunately, he's there right now. So that's, so I guess, says again a lot about Todd's done with him, a lot what he's done to come that type of player that he is.
How about the advancement, Doc, of Litton from now another week in the job?
And I think every time you see him grow, you know, and, you know, I thought, you know, in his conditions out there, I thought that we were in on Saturday night. I thought, number one, he had zero turnovers, which was important. And he saw things break down a couple times, and he found ways to keep his eyes downfield and make plays and just continue to watch him grow. But he has to continue to do that. You know, he has to keep getting better every week. And we got to keep getting better offensively every week, as we do in all other phases, on special teams and also defense. We just got to work hard to get better every week. And this week we're going to do
it. Back-to-back weeks of 100 yards for Tony Pittman. What did the progression you saw from Kent State through this past week from him?
Yeah, just a little bit more comfortable, you know, because he's played now. You know, and anytime a guy, anybody can gain some experience. I think the game slows down for him a little bit. We got a better understanding of what we're trying to get done. And he looked a little more comfortable out there. And made more of the right reads. And did a good job with the ball team.
Litton's hitting all his receivers, but he seems to have a chemistry with Juracek. Juracek got him out of trouble last week for your longest game of the gain of the day, for example.
He does. So whether that's by accident or it's just, sometimes that normally happens, when you get to, Cato's security blanket with Shuler all those years. Right now, but Juracek's a good player too. I mean, he knows Juracek's going to make a play. But Devontae Allen, McMahon has played well. Of course, Reeves is playing well too. So, all four of those guys need to step up and continue to get better and continue to play well because we're going to need them.
How important was it? It seemed like the first couple throws were to Deontay and Devontae both, and it got them involved early. And it seemed like it really helped with the
contest. It does. I mean, any receiver out there, it keeps those guys forever. You get them involved early, they like to catch balls, and that's why they're receivers. So you get them involved and get them going in the game, I think it does help. But he did that with both those guys early on Saturday.
Now that you've had a chance to look at the film from Saturday, how impressive was the immediate impact of Sean Pettit getting to a ball game?
I thought he was, for the first time, I mean, he hadn't played in a couple of years, he's rusty a little bit, but, athletically, he's a tremendous athlete. I saw a lot of different things out of him. I saw that one fourth down stop where he stuck his face in there and was very physical, which he wanted to see. He saw him run and make plays in space. You know what kind of athlete he is. So, I thought for the first time, he hadn't practiced. He practiced last week. It was the first time he practiced in about 4 weeks, I think it is, as far as running around doing the entire practice. So I thought for a guy that hadn't played football very long and hadn't practiced much in the last 4 to 5 weeks, I thought he was pretty impressive. So I think he'll continue to get better.
Are you all happy with where you're at with depth, with Ryan B. emerging and Petty coming in?
Ryan B's kind of a little bit of a. I thought he was going to be a good player. I didn't think he'd quite be where he is right now. And he's taken off and played extremely well, as you all know.
You get some of your banged up guys back?
I think Devin and I have a great shot at practice today, I think. And so I think we'll get some of them back. We need to.
Corey Tindall having one pick in the game, had almost another one. What was it that really got him going early, and how important is that for him to take that momentum forward toward Mullins this week?
That's huge. I mean, really, Nick Mullins is a tremendous quarterback. They got tremendous skill. They got four or five wideouts that can flat go. They got two tailbacks that are extremely good players. This will be our biggest test today, defensively, as far as quality of skill we're going to see, the quality quarterback we're going to see, and the quality running backs. There's reason number one early in total offense. And they played Nebraska extremely tough, played Mississippi State really tough. So it's going to be a great challenge for our defense. And anxious to go watch them. I think our defense is pretty good too, so we'll see how they match up.
Mentioned the running backs. They've got three guys who carried the ball for them this season. What do each of them bring for Southern Miss offense?
They all bring speed. They're all a little different, but they're all really athletic. They do a good job of. You look at the number of catches their backs have as a total group. And they get the ball to their backs out of the backfield. They all do a great job with ball skills. They all carry extremely well. They're physical. And they can make plays in space. And they can have a flat out run. So that's what you're looking for in back, all three of them.
They like to take some chances too. And last year, you all found that out firsthand. They came out with a couple onside kicks. And you got to be ready for everything.
They've done five of them this year. They we've got, I think, four of them. So, I mean, it's, you know, they do a great job of doing it. You know, our guys will work all week on it. We'll work all week and have guys in the right position. At some point, you have to go make a play. And I watch Southern Miss, or I watch Mississippi State not make a couple of them. Watch Nebraska not make a couple of them. They've done it just about every game, so they feel comfortable doing it. I'm sure we'll probably see them too. So we'll work hard all week, and find somebody's got a time coming for them.
Doctor, did he do anything special to get the program back, or just kind of stay the course and do
say
his thing?
I'm sorry.
Did Coach Munkin do anything?
Yeah, I think he stayed the course. You know, I think he didn't flinch. You know, he stayed, followed the plan, his plan to win, whatever that is. You know, he stayed the course, didn't flinch, and recruited good players. You know, and that's what it's all about. I think he's done a good job of, you know, of taking that, because, you know, you all have watched him for the last 4 years, and they've just made such great progress. He deserves an awful lot of credit. He's done a great job.
That's a tough situation too, because a lot of those kids were on their third coach in the span of three seasons.
It's a tough situation, but you know where they're located. A number of football players that are around there. He can recruit some good players. He's gone in there and he's done a good job evaluating kids, and he's got good players in there. And he's had to take his lumps for a couple of years because he's playing a lot of young kids. And that quarterback we were talking about was a freshman, I think, when he was out there last time. So it's hard to. We all know what playing freshman quarterbacks, you go through some growing pains, and he did. But now he's got to take it where he wants it.
Is there any concern at all getting your guys ready to play against a team you've beaten pretty soundly the last couple times you played them?
I don't think so. No. If there is, I got problems. I mean, they have. You know, our guys, they study a lot of tape and they work hard at what they do, and just turn film. I mean, it's obvious if you turn the film on, watch them play, that they're an excellent team, and you know, we got to be prepared to play, or we'll. So our guys, and we'll make sure as coaches they understand that. So that has not been an issue getting them ready to play every week. And they just got to continue to get better and not make mistakes. Can take care of the football and do what we do in the games.
Coach Munkin brought in a number of JUCOs and maybe about five fifth-year transfers. How much of a different look does it give that team?
Well, it does. You know what he's got. You guys all know there's about how many junior colleges there's right there in the state of Mississippi. There's about so the best junior college football in America is played in Mississippi, and there's six or eight of them right there, you know. So he just has such a wealth of talent right there. I mean, they get in the car and drive, you know, right around their campus there, and there's just so many JUCO players and all that. And he's done a great job, to his credit again, of getting those kids there and developing them. So I didn't think it would take long to get that thing back. I wish it would take them longer than it has, but it has.
One thing you notice on film is the fact that they're protecting balls a lot better than what they have in previous years too.
Yeah, they're playing two offensive lines. They're rolling two offensive lines in there, playing a lot of kids. And like I say, they've done a great job. My hat's off to them. And it's good for the league. It's good for the league. It's good for our conference that they're back where they were, because it's good for all of us.
In terms of their defense, how have they changed since last year? It seems like their points allowed per game has dropped drastically.
They have better players. They've become better players because the younger guys have grown up, and they've added some guys to the group, and they're coaching them extremely hard. And I'm sure the off-season program now, you know, they're going their third year with the same strength coach, and they're doing a good job of developing the off-season. And like I say, Todd's done a great job of following his plan to win, and it's develop players, recruit good players, and coach them up. They're doing all three of those things.
A lot of your players have talked about how exciting it is to play at night. Is it more exciting to coach during night games as well?
I don't know. It's like night or day. I don't know. It never changes a whole lot. All I know is a pregame meal before I went 3 hours before the game, whatever it is, go play. But I think our kids, we talk a little bit, they talk about Friday night lights. You know, it's like the old high school days, I guess. You turn the lights on and go play. So we just need a great crowd in here. You know, we need to get just like the Purdue game, we got to have a great atmosphere. And it's Friday night, the weather's going to be great. Pack that place and have a heck of a night. But I know our players will have a lot of fun because, number one, we're playing at home. It's going to be a great crowd. And as long as they're having fun, I guess I will be too.
You've experienced a short week already. For a lot of the younger guys that are playing, how beneficial is it to have already had a short week of practice before going into something this?
I think it's a pain in the neck, to be honest. But we've done it. I mean, we've been there. We've done that. So today's Tuesday and tomorrow's Wednesday. Let's go. I mean, just go. They don't tell what day it is. They can show up and go play, I guess. But it's a little bit, it's probably harder on the coaches than it is on the players because the preparation goes into it. I mean, we've had to put 2 days of preparation into 1 day and a half days to get ready for today's practice. You just don't go out on the field and practice, you know, from the week before. It's all the preparation that goes into it, from the film breakdowns and everything that the defensive offensive coaches do to get ready for practice on a Tuesday. Well, here it is Monday. So we've had to get 2 days worth of work done in 1 day. So I'd say it's probably not a hard problem. It is harder on the coaches than it is the players.
How late were y'all here Saturday night?
Coach Heater never goes to bed, so he goes to bed, but he's up about 2-3 a.m, I guess. But they get your work done. You know, we don't give them hours, just do whatever you got to do to get your work done. And they're all tremendous coaches that work extremely hard, so I'm not concerned about how many hours they're here. I just know that when the day rolls around, we're about to practice the floor.
You mentioned last week and the week before that Birdsong's finally get to throw a little bit more. Has he been able to really get in there and kind of push Chase a little bit more than Chase?
He's threw a little bit in practice.